Nightwish is a symphonic metal band that has sold nearly 10 million studio albums. They are not only one of the most successful symphonic metal bands, but for many, they are a source of hope and deliverance. You are watching Metal Ground. If you like to watch YouTube or Facebook reactions, you might have encountered thousands and thousands of people talking and suggesting Nightwish videos. And then we have the YouTubers and vocal coaches amazed by the type of music Nightwish produce. People start crying and tear up while listening to their music. But how is a symphonic metal band capable of bringing such emotions? Who is the mastermind of this particular band? What happened to their ex-vocalist, Tarja and Annette? My name is Alex, and I invite you to stay tuned, because in this two-part introduction, we will talk about this and more. First part, we will talk about Nightwish band history, and on the second part, we will go over the different Nightwish music eras, so we can listen to their amazing music. Nightwish is a symphonic band formed in 1996. Their sound has evolved and changed through the years, in part because of their different vocalist. Their music has become more and more complex. We can agree that Nightwish combined many elements to create their unique sound: gothic, epic, theatrical, operatic, and melodic. Nightwish released their first album, Angels Fall First, in 1997, but they did not achieve wider success until years later with the release of their following albums. Oceanborn was released in 1998, Wishmaster in 2000, and Century Child in 2002. We can say that their sound is a little more operatic and towards the gothic style. In 2004, they released Once, an album that has sold more than 1 million copies and was the band's breakthrough in the United States. Wish I Had an Angel received MTV airplay and was included on 3 US film soundtracks to promote their North American tour. The band produced 3 more singles and 2 music videos for Once, as well as a re-recording for Sleeping Son for the compilation album Highest Hopes, The Best of Nightwish in 2005. Tarja Trunen was dismissed from the band that same year. Her last performance with Nightwish was during a concert recorded for the live album DVD, End of an Era. After the concert, the other members informed Tarja with an open letter that she was no longer a member of Nightwish. In interviews, the band's members said that Tarja's husband was too controlling and that he was trying to interfere with her decisions and the future of her career in the band. With Tarja being gone, many people thought that the end of Nightwish had come. However, Nightwish sent an announcement saying they were looking for a new singer. Meanwhile, Tarja launched a new solo career, and with that, her first solo album in 2007, My Winter Storm, achieving a great success on her own. She released many more albums since, but we will cover those in a different video. In May 2007, Nightwish announced Annette Olsson to be Turunen's replacement, but kept the whole album as a secret, creating a lot of speculation about the singing style and capabilities of their new singer. That September, the band released their 6th album, Dark Passion Play, one of the most sold albums of the band. In March 2009, they released their 7th studio album, Imaginarium. A few years later, in 2012, the band released Imaginarium, a fantasy film. Even if Nightwish was reaching new frontiers, many Nightwish fans lost interest in the band due to Annette's singing style. Tarja was a very well-trained lyric soprano with a dark tone voice, and Annette had little to none experience participating with a small rock band before Nightwish. She was not even considered a light soprano until later on her career. Annette, of course, improved considerably through the years. Her live vocals became amazing, along with her energetic and kind personality. But that was not enough. In 2012, Nightwish announced that they had parted ways with Olsson, and will be finishing the tour with Jansen. After her departure, Olsson also released a solo project called Shine, and went silent for a little while due to the little success of the project. Annette's redemption and resurrection came a few years later with a project called The Dark Element. Annette has also had many other collaborations, and we will talk about them in a different video. For now, let me tell you that she just announced her 2nd solo album, and more news will come soon. In October 2013, Nightwish announced that Jansen was now their full-time vocalist. Jansen mended Nightwish vocalist decisions as she was able to sing melodies created for Tarja, but also songs made for Annette. To learn more about Flor Jansen's music and career, watch my full review on her. I will add the link on that description. Endless Forms Most Beautiful was released on March 2015, and finally Human Nature in 2020. All band members of Nightwish had achieved great admiration. Tuomas Holopainen is the mastermind behind Nightwish, being the main composer, songwriter, and keyboardist. Tuomas' side projects include Ari and the Life and Times of Scrooge. Then we have Marko Jetala. He replaced Sami Vanska as the bassist. Jetala has also taken over male vocal previously filled by Tuomas and other guest singers. Some side projects of Jetala include his participation as a lead vocalist on Tarot, his personal project Pyre of the Black Heart, and Northern Kings. Empu Vuorinen, the guitarist, has also worked as a guitarist for the Finnish hard rock band Brother Fire Tribe. Then we have Troy Donnelly, an English multi-instrument composer. And finally we have Kai Hatto, who replaced Jukka Nevalainen in 2014. Jukka is still involved with Nightwish in an administrative position. And there you have it, I hope I have covered most of Nightwish history and facts. Another announcement I would like to make is that due to COVID-19, crew members of Nightwish lost much of their income by the cancellation of shows. You can support them buying their one-time special album Crewish, released on September 18. You can check my review and samples on this particular project. Please see the second part of this video, we will be able to see the evolution of the band through the years. Don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you next time.